So we just talked about a single level sort, or what I refer to as a quick sort. Click into the column, go to your data tab, choose your order, ascending, descending. Now that's great, and it's super quick. The second technique that I want to talk about here in sorting the list deals with a multi-level sort. I want to sort this list by multiple columns. Now this one is very quick as well, but a few extra steps. Take a look. I want to get into this list, same employee records list, and I want to sort it not just by last name, but I now want to sort it by last name and first name. So I want to do two levels here. Take a look. So first, I'm going to click into my list. Now at this point, because I'm doing multiple columns, it really doesn't matter which column you click into, just as long as you're in the list itself. Once I'm in that list, I'm going to go up to my data tab. I'm going to go back into the sort and filter area, but this time I'm going to go to the big sort button. I'll give that a click. This opens up my custom sort window. Now within here, I can do several things. You'll notice that I currently have one sort order in here. I can see that I'm sorting by column last name. I'm going to sort on the values, meaning the values within that column, the last name values, and I'm going to sort in ascending order. Now this is just one level. I want to add a secondary level, a secondary sort. Up in the top left corner, I'll hit the add level button. This adds my second level sort. Now here, I'm going to go grab first name. I'll continue to sort on values. I'll continue to do an ascending order sort, and I'll hit OK. And I've now sorted my list, first primary sort by last name, secondary sort by first name. Take a look. Now, if I scroll through this list, it may not look like first name is sorted. They're kind of all over the place. But what's happening here is it's creating groups. Last name was sorted first. So now I've got A, B, C, and so on. But anytime that there's more than one employee with the same last name, like Berwick, it's a group. And within that group, it's now sorting first name and ascending order. You can see Elaine and Sam. Here's Corwick, Judy and Rob, J and R. If I scroll down, let's find Smith. There's 1, 2, 3, 4 Smiths, right? Over on the right, I'll see B, E, H, H, A, H, O, and there we go. I've sorted two levels, last name and then first name. Simple, simple. Click into your list, head up to your data tab, go to the big sort button. You got your custom sort or your multi-level sort window open, and you can add levels. Here's an FYI for you. Now, ever since 2007 of Excel, you can sort up to 64 levels. Think about that. If you ever need to do that, I want to know why. Jump into the discussion board within this course and let us know why you need 64 levels. That just seems like it's a huge number and something I'll never use. For me personally, 2, 3, maybe 4 levels occasionally, that's about my cap. Okay, but 64 levels now. Have a go. Try it out. To your heart's content, you can go. You can sort a ton inside of Excel. So try this out.